And I'm very honored to be in front of you today with this amazing group of kids, and we have a fantastic lineup for you. I'm really, really proud of the work they've put in. They have put in a lot of work, and they're very excited to play for you today. These are kids from all over St. Louis and St. Charles County, and as you can see, for those of you who might have seen us in the past, we are growing, and that is because of word of mouth and teachers having their students audition, and for that, I truly thank you, because we are doing some awesome things here, and it is because we have a nice team that we can work with. So thank you all for that, for getting your students here every day, or every weekend. sorry, I'm a little nervous actually. So, and I talk much better in front of children than I do adults. So, but without further ado, we will get started.
Thank you.
before we play our final piece, my goal with these kids is always to, some of these kids have never played in an orchestra before, so this is their first orchestra concert. They've had recitals, they've had solos, they may have had a duet or a trio or some sort of group ensemble, but being in a true orchestra setting for some people, this is their first time, and they've done an amazing job. I'm really, really proud of that. The last piece was a piece that I wasn't going to do this year. I've been playing this piece since 2008 with my own school orchestra. And this year, with the exception of 2016 and 2020, and this year, I was not going to do it. And the students were practicing and they were messing around in rehearsal, as children do. And I kept hearing them do these slides and these sound effects, and I was like, I know the perfect piece for this group. And so I pulled out the piece that we're playing next, which is Twas the Night Before Christmas. And I know it was played here a few years ago, but it's so much fun for these guys, and they have, they've pulled it off. I pulled it out to them fairly at the last minute, and they have come together and really pulled it off. So I'm very excited. Our narrator this evening is, or this afternoon, is Jerry Herbert. He's my father, and he's narrated every year since we've done this. So I could not ask him again, so I'm gonna have him come up here, and then without further ado, Twas the Night Before Christmas. So thank you all. It's just so wonderful working with your children and if your families of these children, or if you're their teachers, thank you for working with them, because it would not come together without their hard work. So thank you so much.
I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash. Tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow gave the luster of midday to objects below. When what to my wondering eye should appear but a miniature sleigh and a tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be Saint Nick. Thank you. Rabbithan Eagles, his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted,
"Go Reindeer!"
and called them by name. To the top of the wall. Now dash away, dash away, dash away all. As dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly. When they meet with an obstacle bound to the sky. So up to the housetop, the coursers they flew. With a sleigh full of toys and St. Nicholas too. And then in a twinkling, I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound. Dressed all in fur, from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled. His dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow. And the beard on his chin was as white as the snow. And the smoke, it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a round little belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump and a right jolly old elf. And I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work, and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk, and laying his finger aside of his nose, and giving a nod up the chimney, he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle.
Thank you all so much and have a happy holiday.